Hello, John Talley here with Boats.net, and sitting before you in the stand is a MerCruiser Sterndrive. This particular one is a Bravo 2 X diesel, and it has a pretty severe problem. It actually has a large crack on the lower unit casing, as you can see here. So what are we going to do? Well, we're going to clean off a large section of table on one of my workbenches, remove the top section, and then break down the lower unit. We'll determine what we can and can't use and then get it rebuilt. So if you're ready, I'll go open up my toolbox and we will dive into this. So let's go. Step one, let's bend our tabs back, retaining washer. Yeah, two of them. Let's see if she'll come loose now. I don't know who put that on, but that's a little scary. Basically, the only thing holding that on was the retaining washer. Now, what I'm about to do now, you wouldn't do because you run the risk of cracking the casing, but ours is already cracked, so I can get away with this. Next, we're going to pull both the vent and the drain plug, drain slash fill plug. And this ought to be interesting. That'll tell us whether or not we've got any water intrusion up into the housing itself. Now you should be able to actually see the bolts that I'm removing. On the other side, it was a mirror image. One going up and then two coming down. One there and then one about right here. And then you've got one hidden all the way back, right in front of the sacrificial anode. And they are all 16 millimeters. So we've got our six up front taken out. Now we're just gonna reach up in here and get number seven. As I was saying, white dust. I'm just glad it came out. Now let's see if they want to separate. Yeah. Let's see just how much torque it's going to take. I'm betting not a lot, but hey, I've been wrong before. Yep, it's going to be one of those times I'm wrong. She is probably really encrusted in there. So we're going to get a bigger breaker bar. So we'll try it with the air. If that still doesn't get it, then we're going to get out the torch and heat up the casing. And if that still doesn't get it, then we have to drill it out and knock out the retaining rigging itself. We'll start with this, see what happens, see if it holds, and then adjust accordingly. So what we're gonna do next is grab a regular slide hammer, see if we can attach to this point and get that other side to pop loose. Let's see, and she's probably gonna try to spin on me, but let's pop it. It's holding on for dear life on this half. Of course, this side is literally broken away on the bearing carrier. What I'm gonna do is get a cutoff wheel and cut reliefs here, here, and here, and hopefully that'll be enough where it'll finally pop it loose and get out of there. And if we have to cut more reliefs to get this to break out, then that's what we'll do. From the looks of the inside, the internals, I think they're still usable. We should be able to get away with just replacing the bearings and the seals, and of course, the housing and the carrier. and be able to use the shafts, the pinion gears, I mean, everything else. Let's remove the pinion gear bolt next, and it is a 14 millimeter head below. And then we have to have a special tool to hold the input shaft spline, and then a 32 millimeter socket up top on the tool. There we go. There she is. Get our plate removed. Of course, we'll be reusing the plate later in the game, but that is when we go back to check the play in the pinion gear to see if we need to adjust our shims, which we probably will. Now, with our clamp plate removed, we still need to get the O-ring, a spacer, any shims that are in there, along with a tab washer. Now, once those are out of the way, the drive shaft will lift out, and then the pinion gear will drop out below. Yeah, there we go. So, let's see if we can get in here and get that O-ring out. There we go. And the thrust ring. There she is. Other than having a really big crack in the housing, the drive is actually in pretty good shape. So I've got all the pieces that I'm actually going to use already removed, but if you did want to reuse your bearings, I want to go ahead and show you how to pull the races so you can reinstall yours in the new housing. Now, all I'm going to use is just a regular slide hammer puller. Just make sure it's got a set of claws that are opposable and can reach down inside of the diameter of the races themselves. Then let's pop them out. There you go. Now we're going to remove the bearing race for your front bearing. We're going to use the same setup with our slide hammer and just pop it out. Same scenario as up top. You're going to see the race itself, and then whatever shims that were required to get the correct clearance. Looks like there was just one. Well, all right, guys, that's pretty much all we're going to extract out of this particular casing, because you're not going to reuse needle bearings or any other bearings for that matter once you've knocked them out, or at least I'm not going to. So now that I know what I need, I'm going to head in, order out the parts that are going to be required, and then we'll start putting this back together. Well, listen, if whatever you need for your boat, why don't you come see us at boats.net and we can get you taken care of. If you have any questions or comments about what we've done so far, why don't you leave them in the section below and I'll do my best to answer them. And hey, you like what you see? Why don't you go ahead and hit that subscribe button? That way you can keep up with whatever I'm working on next. We just want to say thank you for shopping here with us at boats.net, and we will see you in the next video. Y'all have a great day.